Hi everyone, Saeed here. Designing infographic shapes is one thing, and how to use them properly is another issue. Today I'm going to show you how to design these beautiful infographic slides in PowerPoint. I know, it looks a little complicated, but let me tell you that it is so easy to design. So let's dive in and design it together. Let me start by drawing a circle. Set its diameter to 6 and align it to the middle and center. Right-click on the shape and select Format Shape. In the Fill section, increase the transparency of the shape to 50%. Alright, duplicate it and change its diameter to 2.79. Hold the Ctrl key down and make two copies of it. First, align this circle to the center, then hold the Ctrl key down and select the big circle, then align them to the bottom. Press Ctrl G to group them and send them back. Now we have to rotate the group 120 degrees. So go to the Size section and rotate it 120 degrees. Now select the group and ungroup it. If you notice, the big circle is rotated and I have to put it to the first position. So select it and in the Size section, change the rotation to 0. Again, align this circle to the center, then select the big circle as well and align them to the bottom. Hold the Ctrl key down and select the other circle, then press Ctrl G to group them and send them back. Now we have to rotate the group 120 degrees. Bring the last circle to the inside and align it to the center. Also select the big circle and align them to the bottom. But there is a problem. Can you tell me what did we wrong? First of all, we forgot to ungroup the shapes. Second of all, we forgot to reset the rotation of the big circle. Right now, the bottom of big circle is here. So when I align them to the bottom, it will be like this. So to solve this problem, I have to first reset the rotation of big circle. If you notice, the bottom of shape is here now. For the next move, I have to align this shape to the center and finally align them to the bottom. Alright, everything is ready. For those of you who are wondering how did I calculate these diameters, it is just some simple mathematical calculations. In case if you are interested, you can calculate it yourself. Anyway, press Ctrl A to select all the shapes, then from the Shape Format tab in the Merge Shape menu, select the fragment. We don't need this part, so you can delete it. Now select these two shapes and make them union. Repeat this for other parts as well. If you notice, there are some extra outlines inside the shapes. It is because PowerPoint is not precise. And sometimes it happens during the fragment. To remove them, from the Insert tab, select the Freeform shape and draw it like this. Don't forget to connect the joint at the end. If you want a precise adjustment, zoom in a little bit, then right-click on the shape and select Edit Points, and adjust it precisely. Now select the main shape first, then the small one, and make them union. As you see, the extra outline is gone. Repeat this for other shapes. Let me draw a rectangle the size of the slide and send it back. Change its color to dark blue. Now select all the shapes and fill them with white color. Also, change the color of the outlines to black and choose a thicker line. First, let me remove the transparency of the shapes. Then go to the line section and set the transparency to 95%. I am going to add an inner shadow to the shapes as well. Select the center inner shadow and change its color to blue and set the blur amount to 60%. Now press Ctrl G to group them and decrease its diameter to 4.25. All right, so far so good. So far so good means if you like this video so far, please like and subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell for additional upcoming videos. And I forgot to mention that you can download the template for free in the description. Let's get back to the video. Now I'm going to add some text boxes and icons to the slide. From the Insert tab, click on the icons and select your suitable icons. Since the topic of this PowerPoint is about COVID, I choose the icons that are related to it. Adjust each icon to its position. Also, from the Insert tab, add your titles. Now select all of them and by pressing Ctrl G, group them. Let me rotate it to see if all the items are well positioned or not. Alright, now I am going to design the slide. Reduce the size of the rectangle to the half size of the slide. I mean, change its height to 3.75. Now hold the Ctrl and Shift keys down and duplicate it. Then align it to the bottom. And send it back. Also, change its color to the light blue. Draw a rounded rectangle and align it to the middle. Let's fill it with a gradient fill. In this case, I am using two colors with linear type. Now select all the rectangles and send them back. Let me add a drop shadow in this direction to this rectangle. Set the transparency to 0, blur to 60, and distance to 12. Again, draw a rounded rectangle and remove its color and choose white color for the outline. Add another rectangle to the slide and by using the eyedropper tool, choose this color for it. Also, add a drop shadow in this direction to it. Set the blur amount to 25 and distance to 12. Let me decrease the transparency as well. If you want, you can add your title to the slide. Bring your picture to the slide and crop it with 4:5 aspect ratio. Adjust the picture inside the crop, then decrease its height to 4. Repeat this for other pictures. Let's align all the pictures according to their order. Select all of them and align them to the center. Then select Distribute Vertically from the menu. Press Ctrl G to group them and drag the first picture to its position. Now select a slide in the slide ribbon and by pressing Ctrl D, duplicate it. First, hold the Shift key down and rotate this shape 120 degrees. Then drag the second picture to its position. And finally, edit your title. Again, duplicate the slide and repeat all the steps. For the last part, I'm going to create a slide with the main title. So select the first slide in the ribbon, then duplicate it. Go to the first slide and press Ctrl A to select all the shapes, then hold the Ctrl key down and deselect these two rectangles. Now you can delete the rest of them. Drag these two to the outside and add your main title to the slide. Go to the second slide and select all the shapes, but deselect these two rectangles. Now from the Animation tab, add Fly In Animation to them. Select Start with Previews and increase the duration to 2 seconds. Click on the Animation pane and while all the animations are selected, right-click on one of them and select the Effect option. In this window, set the Bounce End to 1 second, then click on OK. For the last step, select one of the slides in the slide ribbon, then by pressing Ctrl A, select all of them and add morph transition to them. Now your PowerPoint is ready.